Right. Let's have a walk through. It's quiet today. It is a Tuesday. But we don't normally we go boot fair on Tuesday, but I very much doubt there'll be a boot fair on today. So we'll just go through and give it what for. And let it run. I'll just wait for my friend to ring me back and I'll be right. So, here we go. So, if you haven't subscribed to the blog, welcome to the Alan Payne's Daily Blog on YouTube. Preston today, and yeah, so yeah, this is right, and you know, this is a privately owned shopping centre. It used to be owned by the Duke of Lancaster, but yeah, so you know, it's just one of them things, ain't it? What happens. People don't like filming in shopping centres. Don't like you filming in shopping centres because. Basically, they don't like to show how well or how bad they're doing. And sometimes it's just one of those things that happens. My friend who has a channel at Blackpool, he was asked to stop filming at Hounds Hill. And what the people at Hounds Hill don't really... and a lot of the shopping centres don't realise, any publicity is good free publicity, and that's the way it goes sometimes. As once again, it's a Tuesday and the flea market is not open today due to the situation. You know, they don't want to do any business. One of the rumours I have been hearing is that a lot of the people who do the boot fair, on the Tuesdays, have basically started doing this sort of boot fair thing online, and so you might see more eBay items going up. For boot fairs, so you know, if you haven't liked and subscribed to the Alan Kane's Daily Blog YouTube channel, please take the opportunity to do so. So we're just gonna go through. So. They have some really good stuff on here, really, you know, food-wise, and you can't really fault it, really. So, you know, it's just one of those things. Got some really good vegetables and fruit here, so come down and get your lovely vegetables and fruit. They're really nicely priced as well, so. You know, got several meat stalls and stuff, and we have basically quite a few cafes on the Preston Market. Lots of them are just basically doing takeout at the moment because of the situation that we're in. And that was a quick glimpse of Preston Market. We're going to go down between the two now, that field over the far side there. You've got Switch nightclub, which is not open at the moment. You've got Iceland, and yeah, because like if you have the chance, please like and subscribe and press the bell button for it for when I pull up more content. Jenny's not with me today, but well she was with me today, but she wasn't really willing to come over to Preston today. Yeah, as I'm walking through. We'll see what happens. We'll have a look at see what this construction is down. I've been hearing that that they're doing construction work at the bottom here. I've got a funny feeling that they're going to start knocking through some of the shops that have left, and basically putting a bigger store in their place. But the thing is, nobody's saying who's going there. So you know, we'll see what happens. Because at this moment in time, it's just closed off. We'll just go for a glimpse on the outside, see what the situation is, and see what they've been basically doing. As I said, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do so. We also detail the death of retail, of which this situation is basically causing. And people don't really realise how bad the situation is going to get. And yeah, the major thing about Preston, it's a university town, it's a university city really, shall I say. And you know, we're just trying to find out how much the place is getting hit. Well, they still haven't started what they're going to be doing here. They're probably doing the cleaning up of the place. I know the Chinese restaurant at the bottom is going to be basically renovated to something else. And we'll see what happens. But so far, the conversion process hasn't been carried out yet, so we'll see what happens to this area. Because they did, and they were boarded. They boarded it off, but we'll see what happens. This has been sealed up a little bit more than what it was before. But this used to be the Chinese restaurant at the bottom, and it's got at least three floors on it. And what they're going to do with that, I don't know. So what we're going to do, we're going to try and wrangle and see if we can get ourselves in the shopping area and see what's what. So I won't be able to film in here unless someone catches us out. So yeah, I'll let you know we'll have a walk through, but I will have to kill the camera for a bit. Yeah. There is a company now that has bought We've bought, I think it's the Divine Melt Company. Right. Have a look around, see what's happening. Right, okay. The five mouth companies buying. We'll just have a look to see what the situation is. It's a bit. It's a bit sad. We'll have a look. So what's what? A bit sad. Hello. See what the situation is. Just hits his car. Bird King's glass. Hang on, how come this bird open? Fucking bird open. Bird King's glass. The rumour is that New Look is closing. So we'll soon find out. It's as dead as black there. It really is. Dead as black there. Dead as black there. But, it's unfortunate, so. The fact is, it said New Look might be closing. Well, go up the escalator. No bars are not allowed open. Holland Barrett's open because it's upstairs. Yeah, it's upstairs. Let's see what's happening. the farm stall is open. We go upstairs. Upstairs, see what's open. But we'll have to come back this later. Let's see what's open. Chimney open. Yeah. Right.
Is there anything
I can help you with? No, let's see what you've got.
It is just the one-way system, so it's just on the right and just
yeah,
around.
Okay. Thank you very much. Glad you've got in. Okay. Do you need any headphones? No, not really. I'm going to go on the street, let's see next door. Took all the stuff out. Cheers. That's the Beauty Omega. Beauty Omega. GT Ultimate Racing Seat. We'll find out. You're right.
Hi, are you okay?
Yeah, you don't have a prize for the GT Racing Seat, yeah?
I do, Joe.
There's
a good
attack
for you.
So what's the price are you looking at?
Bear with me 2 seconds.
Just have a price for everything.
£190. So it's $189.99, yeah,
to
start
a price on them. Right, yeah. Right. Okay, well, I'll leave it to now, alright?
Alright, no problem.
Yeah, I can get it for a lot less than that. Let's have a look. Let's go. Let's have a look at chair. I need a new chair, you see. Because my chair is busted.
Yeah.
I tried to find out. It's 190 quid for that. 190 quid for that. I'm sorry, but that is just totally. That's absolutely totally ridiculous. Totally ridiculous. Yeah, totally ridiculous that was. Totally ridiculous. We'll just have a walk, quick walk around and see what's what up here. Yeah, it's quite a few empty shops up here. We'll come back. Don't think so. Claire's is shut. Just basically have a walk around. It's absolutely, it's more dead than what Blackburn is. More dead than what Blackburn is. Jesus. Absolutely dead. Yep, it's completely full of bugs. It's one person at a time. That's super good. New look. Now, this is another company that's actually in trouble. Yeah, bit of a mess is New Look. 16 billion dihar in 16 billion debt they have, and it's not good news for them. A large number of shopping centres basically are going to basically go to the wall. And it's not good for them. It's not good news for them. And it's 6 of one and a half a dozen of the other, and it's going to be more of a hard slog for them. I know the Dubai Mall's company has been buying up been buying up one or two companies. Yeah, we'll soon see what happens. Is it one of the time persons again? Right, we'll soon find out. I'm going to put right across. Oops. You all right?
Hey, Paul, you right?
Yeah. Have you heard?
What's that?
You've changed the social distancing.
Oh, I'm glad you've done it already.